and gents, Louise Wenner.
Hello.
Hello.
You look great.
So do you.
Thank you.
I remember when your first single, Sleeper, came out in 1995. I was 15.
15, oh my God. Mm. I feel really old now.
Yeah, but you still look great. And I remember I used to think about you a lot while I was busy. We do all remember the whole Britpop era. Let's just have a little look at the Sleeper heyday. 1995 was your debut appearance on Top of the Pops. He's not a prince, he's not a king, she's not a worker or anything. It makes no sense, another year. What kind of age is that? We'll get you here. It's nothing special, she's not too smart. You start with fashion, she starts art. I think I told you. It's got to be some great memories, hasn't it? When you see that back, what do you think?
It's brilliant. I feel really nostalgic. I mean, I wanted to go on Top of the Pops since I was a really little kid.
Yeah.
I don't know about you, but I mean, I used to tape it off of the television. I used to have a little sort of tape recorder, and every Thursday night I'd just get it and put it up against the speaker and tape Top of the Pops.
What, you just tape it on an audio tape recorder?
An audio tape recorder, and just play it back sort of week after week. And I had loads of these tapes.
Talking of the Britpop years, I think we've got a photo of you. There you go, there's... You, Jarvis, Damon Albarn, and that unpronounceable fellow from the Boo Radleys. What's he called?
His name is Sice.
That's not a normal name, surely?
It's not a normal name. You shouldn't be allowed to have that name, should you, really?
So what was that in aid of?
It was like a Britpop bonanza where a whole bunch of bands just went in together, and that's kind of where it almost started there, that everyone started calling it Britpop, I think.
Was this around the time when Damon Albarn and Liam Gallagher kicked off with each other?
They were kicking off all the time, weren't
really?
They? Really? Right, I think it was all about who was... shagging whose girlfriend or who wanted to.
One of your band members was an ex.
Yeah.
And one of your band members was your current boyfriend.
That's right.
It's kind of fitting you were called Sleeper in a way.
Well, I didn't sleep with the bass player.
Oh, well, that's all right. Fair enough. Have you ever trashed a hotel room?
I haven't, no, but I always felt bad about doing it because it's not, you know...
Didn't your bass player trash it? Was it your bass player?
Oh, he sort of did. He was really bad with the drink. He couldn't handle it very well, so he would just, like, collapse and think that he had to sort of throw things out of windows and do all this stuff. But then I never wanted to do that because, like, someone who's earning $2.50 an hour has got to come and clear it all up. So it's, like, it's a bit crap, really.
You did live that lifestyle for a few years, is that fair to say?
But it was really weird. One of the biggest clichés when we signed our record deal, mm-hmm. we literally just put the pen on the paper... And someone from the record company was like, well, come this way and, you know, here's a line of cocaine for you all. It was just kind of, such a sort of cliched start to it, but that's really what it's like.
I did read that your, you signing the record deal, the act of you signing your record deal was a really awful experience.
It wasn't an awful experience, but I mean, we didn't sign for very much. I think we signed our record deal for about 12 grand. I think that would have been for the first sort of year, and we were still signing on after, after we'd first... done
a
record
deal.
It's not
grand.
Huge, and people suddenly think, oh, you've got records, or you're like completely loaded immediately. It doesn't really happen that often, I don't think.
Now, you've actually kind of just jacked the whole pop thing in at some point. Why was that? I mean, you did make the decision to just give it up.
Yeah, we've been doing it for 10 years, you know, and the band, we split up, we'd sort of kind of had enough. And I was meant to be just writing songs for a solo album. And someone asked me to write a short story, and I just so enjoyed it. Mm. But we were bitten by the bug.
Right.
And decided to write a novel.
Well, here you go. This is your first novel. It's called Goodnight, Steve McQueen. There you go. Louise Wenner. It is Wenner, isn't it?
Yeah.
Not because there was some debate in the office whether it was Wiener.
Yeah, because it's so bad in America.
Yeah, I bet. Are you that girl, Louise Wiener?
Yeah.
I loved your Sleeper album. So Goodnight, Steve McQueen, can you tell us a bit about it?
It's about three guys in their late 20s that are still trying to make it in a band, and I write it as a guy.
Yeah, the main protagonist is a fella, which is quite unusual for a female author.
Yeah.
Do you find it hard to find the male voice, or not really?
No, I just...
hangs around his pants a lot.
I just spent so long in the back of a van touring around with guys, and I love the sort of the banter and sort of the camaraderie of all of that. There's so much humour in it, and it's a comedy, really, about all about that sort of kind of stuff.
You know, the main fella, he's a little bit... He's not a loser, but
he's a bit of a loser.
Yeah, he's things don't really go very well for him. And I'll read a little extract. Make yourself comfortable, if you want. Needless to say, my teenage years were hell. My friends called me Mooney on account of my lunar landscaped face, and my enemies, of which there were many, called me Twat. It's an experience I've had. I did have a girlfriend, though, Vivian Duxford. She was 15 years old, with eyes the colour of sucked blackjacks, and it was common knowledge that she let boys finger her for chips in the local swimming baths. It was only a matter of time before I plucked up the courage and took my turn. Well, there you go. Before we go any further, I actually have a bag of chips here.
Oh, God.
I was wondering if maybe it was something... No?
Well, Steve, I can smell there's not enough salt and vinegar on that.
No?
So that's where you went wrong.
Oh, it's all right.
More
vinegar on
the chips.
We can have some brought in by the end. Put some salt and vinegar on them. I've dreamed of this. I've dreamed of this for the past 7 years. have you written two novels now? I mean, this the first one there, Goodnight, Stephen.
I'm halfway through my second one now.
Halfway through the second
yeah.
one. There's a lot of talk about what it's about. You people thought it was about the music industry. You've said it's not at all about the music industry.
Not
any
at
clues?
It's or about do you want to keep gambling.
It about what?
Gambling and poker playing.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Something you've got a lot of experience in?
No, I'm learning, though. It's great. Great game.
Fair enough. You don't get as many groupies in the literary world, do you? Although I imagine you get all the same ones just reading poetry to you. Yeah. Film rights been sold yet?
Not yet, no.
You working on it?
Yeah.
Are you? Good girl. Make a bit of cash. Ladies and gentlemen, please thank Louise Wenner very, very much.